children as example. When they are in a place, or as we are here, when one wants to pee pee, she will come and say, "Daddy, I want to pee pee." They will not depend on their own self. They depend on those who are above them. The disciples never thought of Jesus being with them. They were just following Jesus, like their mind was that, we are helping Jesus to build his ministry. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We are just helping Jesus to build his ministry. So wherever he goes, they follow him. Wherever he comes, they follow him. Don't be a churchgoer. Be a Christian. For as you accepted Christ Jesus as your Lord and your personal Savior, you are under a strong tower. But if you go on your own way, the wall will break. And the devil, after him, he is ready to destroy you. He's ready to destroy you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Until the disciples decided, took a decision, and changed their mind and said, but is Jesus not with us? And we are struggling like this. But he is among us. He's here with you today.
Amen.
Jesus is here with you today.
Amen.
That I will never leave you or forsake you. Wherever you go, he's with you.
Yes.
Even in your bed, he's with you.
Yes.
And so they changed their mind and went and called Jesus. Jesus, save us. We are perishing.
For what?
Why are you perishing? Then he came and stopped the storm. Today, if you will say Jesus, if you will say him and tell him, "Jesus, my Lord, I am perishing, save me," Jesus will save you.
Amen.
Let's take example. Then after the storm, it can come in any way. It doesn't matter whoever you are. Let's take Job as an example. Job was a rich man. He feared God. But the storm of poverty hurt Job and destroy all the things that he has, leaving him with sickness, leaving him with sorrow, and even rejection. His wife said, "My dear, curse your God and die." But Job said, "No. I will hold on to my faith and trust in God. Maybe one day my Redeemer shall speak."
Amen.
Job waited in his soul, in his sorrow and pain, crying unto God that one day he visited him.
Amen.
And he had his healing.
Amen.
And everything that he lost came back.
Yes.
The same thing to the man in the tomb. His family tried to do all that they can, but they could not deliver this man. But as this man was in the tomb, every night this man would be crying. crying. Daytime, this man will be crying, calling upon the power of God to deliver him. He was crying, calling God, that Master, save me. Calling the name of Jesus, Jesus, save me. In all, he was calling day and night, crying, that God will intervene and save him. And truly, one day, he was roaming and he saw Jesus far away. He just went and came and worshiped Jesus, fell at his feet and worshiped him. Then he has his liberty. Today, if you go on your knees and call upon the Lord, he holds the power. And everything is made in him. That storm is in him. He is the head of all. He has the power to stop it. But unless you take a decision and take a step, he will not come. Unless you call upon him, he will not come. Look at this blind man, that Bartimaeus. He was sitting there asking for bread, daily bread. He was blind from birth. He has nothing to do. His parents have nothing to do. They cannot do anything to him. But one day, as he was sitting there, you don't know how he was crying in his spirit, calling God to deliver him from this situation. So, one day, Jesus was passing. He had just heard a noise. I just imagine, you may say, hey, is that my Savior coming? And for this noise, it's not normal noise.
My sister, the storm is there for you, but
It takes you to come out of the storm. The storm is set for you. It takes you to provoke it. Today, Jesus Christ is beside you. What is your storm? And what are you crying for? There's nothing too hard for him. There's nothing too hard for him. There's nothing impossible with him. That call upon me in the days of trouble, I will deliver thee for you to praise me. So he's ready for you. He's just by your side, only waiting for you to call upon him. Maybe you call one or two and then you stop. No. Be like the blind man. Call until you get your results. Call until he comes to your aid. Call until you have your freedom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We thank God. For we serve a living God. Today, what is your problem that you are battling with? You don't have to depend on yourself. You don't have to do your own things. The earlier, the better. At the early stage, you get up and look for the helper. Your helper is close to you. Your helper is close to you.
Amen.
Today, if you will be on your knees and start asking for your help, praying for Jesus Christ to come and save you. Maybe it could be that you have one or two things that is not making you to move. You have to sit down and check yourself and let things go so that your way will be straight for you. Don't battle the storm without the word of God. Don't battle the storm without the word of God. That's your sword. Then Jesus will stand behind you to fight the battle for you. Today, what is your problem? What is the storm that you are fighting day and night by yourself? Jesus said, leave everything unto me. Leave everything unto me. But he needs you, your repentance. He needs your change of mind. Without that, there's no mercy. He will be with you, but he cannot help you. He knows your problem, but he cannot help you. He wants you to take a step of faith, and he will help you. Please be on your feet.